ma'am. Thank you for that introduction. And I'm just 21, yes. Coming on to that, you must be thinking that I'm 21, achieved so much, at least for myself, I don't know about the others. But I'm more or less not satisfied yet. Since TEDx gives me the opportunity to talk about the personal learnings that I've gone through, it's one and one only, which is follow my passion. I don't care personally for who works where, what does. My friends are in IIT, someone's working in Google, someone's working with Microsoft. What am I doing? Kicking a ball. But at the end of the day, that gives me a good night's sleep. I have zero work pressure. I have zero stress on me. As Uncle Sir said that, you know, you should get up and be up for it that yes, I'm going to go work today. I'm like that. My office is a football field. As simple as that. And trust me, it's beautiful. Trust me. Coming to how I started. I was in school. I was dyslexic at one time. In class 5, 6, I could barely read. Not like that is a beeper, but a bit about that. I had issues with it, but at a very young age, I recognized that I'm not good at studies. And I accepted that fact. No matter how hard it was, I would cry, you know, whatever, my family and all. But I accepted it. That was one of the most strongest decisions I ever made. Reason being, I said, yes, I can't study. What do I do next? I started playing sports. I took up cricket, played state. I took up badminton, played state. I took up swimming, I played state. I did table tennis, I played state. Every sport I took up, be that anything, I played state and dropped it. I'm at football when I was 13, 14, 2006. That's late if you want to play football. That's really late. Kids today start at the age of 3 and I train them. 3-year-old kids. So my parents are like, why do you keep dropping it? I say that I achieved something and then I don't feel like I can do any better. But with football it was different. With football it was what I want to do all my life. And I knew it the minute I played it. Why? Those are personal reasons, whatever you stated as you can say it's stylish, it's a team sport, you still have an individual contact to it, whatever. But it gave me the joy that I wanted. I was never, as Uncle Sir, an intelligent boy. I never got 100% in my life till late. Not even in P, I still got a B. Why? Because I was lazy, and I still am. But whatever said and done, that passion inside me never died, and it's still there. A lot of times, my father or family says, ki, in Hindi, obviously, I'm from a Punjabi family, what are you doing? Now, that's not how you should take it, you know. Your family is going to push you. Don't do this. But my single advice, if it makes you happy, do it. Because trust me, at night when you go off to sleep, be that at 12, 2 or 10 a.m. PM. You will sleep happy. Trust me. And when you wake up, you're like, okay, what's today? Let's do it. And that will not at all hamper you. I've been fortunate enough to play for I did my schooling from New Delhi itself. I was in a very good school. I won't take the name. But whatever said and done, they pushed me, yes. In class 8, I started playing with the 12th graders. Probably I was talented. Probably there was no one else playing football. But I still made it. 2007, I went to Europe in the UK to play football. That trip, that 2.5 weeks changed my life. Completely. I was at that time, what, 16? And I felt, buddy, I'm 16. In 3 years' time, I'll be 19. People over there at the age of 19 pay rent to their father. What am I going to do? I'm blessed to be in India. People say that, you know, why are you in India playing football? I'm blessed. At least I don't have to pay rent to my father. It's as simple as that. So, at that time, I started realizing that, you know what, I need to do something. I barely pass my papers. I get a 50 in my half yearlies. Fail in all my unit tests. But in my finals, I get a 70. God knows how. Probably the teachers like me. Anyways, coming on to the footballing aspect, I put in extra hours on it. Extra means extra. I would sleep at 8, get up at 5 in the morning, go to school at 6. Our school started at 7:45. I would train 1 hour 45 minutes non-stop. Non-stop. Every morning. And that's why I say that practice makes a man perfect. But yeah, no one's perfect. So it's in the balance. I started playing football because it was the thing I wanted to do. Now, once I came into the school team, I came back from Bradford, I played over there, came back and I'm like, what's next? I played state, I played zone, I played district, I played nationals. A lot of times I would get selected for national, but for obvious reasons, they, you know, they'd say, nahi, you can't come, you're this, you're that, whatever. One day, I was supposed to fly down to Kashmir, if I'm not mistaken. Kashmir or Bengal, one of the states over there. I was supposed to fly on Thursday. Every day from my school, I traveled to Sona border. That was approximately 25 kilometers one way. I'd get free from school at 2. My reporting time was 4 o'clock. I'd stop at a shop, local shop, have school over today, and go off to play. I'd come home from Sona with the team around 9 p.m. I do my homework, did that, slept, did that full for a month and a half, just to be in the part of the team. Thursday I'm flying out, Monday I get a call. You can't go. Why? Because it's India, whatever. I'm not going to state the obvious. I said that, you know, this is it. I don't want to play football. I almost quit. I was so close to quitting. I didn't. Why? Because I knew Manchester United scouts were coming to India. I said, fine, I'll give it a try. Last try. I still remember the date, it was 2nd October, Gandhiji's birthday. So I gave the tryout, and out of all, I was never famous in school, as in the good books I'd say. Why? Because, where's Akhil Mehra? Field over, man. So no teacher really liked me as such, as per se. Hearts of Hearts, they knew, yeah, he's doing something he likes, let him do it. So they won't stop me also, but they won't even encourage me. So I'm like, I know ma'am wants me to play, so she won't say, okay, you're late or whatever. I got selected, even though our teachers didn't want me to get selected. For one and one reason, why? Abhi nahi padta hai Manchester chala gaya to kya padega? And believe it or not, I still remember, I genuinely, I have a jacket on, as I would have shown you my goosebumps. I'm still up, I have them. I was watching, what do you call, a serial, and I got a call that, you're going to Manchester. I cried that time. Why? Because that is the team I supported since I was young. And that's what I wanted to do. Play for them. Once at least. I was with them for 3.5 weeks, almost, yeah. I trained like a pro. Morning, 6 to 8, you're training. 8 to 9, you have a session. 10 to 11 is breakfast, this is what you've got to have. In Manchester, anyone can go to Manchester. It's a city, anyone's welcome. You can go view the matches, you can go there, check out the stadium, pay, whatever. I trained with them in the Carrington ground. That ground itself cost around 500 million. And you're not allowed entry over there till you're not a player. I wasn't so fortunate to meet my star, like the players I want to be like, as you may say. But I met a few, and it was one of the best. He said, beta, dekho khelaunga main tu aa. I'm like, theek hai sir. I went, first match I didn't play, second match I played, I scored. Third match I started and I scored 2. Fourth match, we were playing against a team, I won't take the name, they targeted me. I jumped 9 feet high for a header. One hit me on my foot, one hit me on my shoulder, and I fell down straight on my shoulder. My collarbone snapped, like that. Straight out. I was rushed to hospital for obvious reasons. My father was there, my mother was there. We consulted three doctors, they told me that, okay, you know, you should have a surgery. We'll put in a pin and we'll have a surgery. And my father said no. Let him do what he wants to, it's his choice. You want a surgery, you do surgery. You don't want a surgery, you don't do surgery. I said no, what is the other choice I have? They said you'll be on bed rest for 3 months. You can't get up on your own. You'll have a nurse 24/7. I said fine, I'll do that. Why? Because if I get that pain in my shoulder, I can't play football to the level I was. I was on bed rest for 2.5 months. I didn't know, I couldn't get up. You must be thinking, collarbone hai, kuch nahi hota. The day you get that injured, right, you can't get up like that on your own. You can't get up like that. I survived that. I came out of injury, I started playing again after, say, 6 months. Bam, another injury. The knee. Doctor said, buddy, leave football or else you can't walk after 2 years. We consulted approximately 4 or 5 doctors. They said, yeah, you won't be able to play football. You know, this will happen, that will happen, technical aspects. I'm like, okay, sir, this, that. Finally, I remember I met a doctor, Mr. Mahajan. By far, I thank him for the life he's given me. He said, that's all crap. I'll fix you up. Give me 2 months. I said, fine. I tried. I worked with him for 2 months, day in, day out. I didn't practice again. And he fixed me, thankfully. I had a ligament issue. A bone was pushing the ligament. So every time I walked on both my knees, I would sustain so much pressure that while running, it could snap any second. The ligament could snap any second. So imagine he has a little bit. She said, my mom was like, now you know it's time to leave football. I said, no. This is what I want to do. And I will. I started doing that. I started taking small jobs. I started playing again football. But then I realized that at this age, agreed, I'm in India. Fine, I can't make it big. That doesn't mean I need to quit. I said that, okay, I can't be a player. I'll be a coach. I started my own football academy by the name of Extra Time Football Academy. For the first 3 months, I had one kid. And I trained that one kid. I dropped, he was overweight, obviously. His mother said, ki football, nah. I was supposed to patla kar do. Football karunga main, patla khud ho jayega. They said, fine, what is your fees, X, Y, Z? I said, ma'am, I want one thing. I will only train him on Saturday, Sundays, from 6 in the morning to 9. They said, why on Saturday, Sundays? There's school days, you can come in the afternoon. I said, no, ma'am. School days, he will just turn up like that, sir, on Saturday, Sunday, the 2 days he have off, if he gets up at 6 a.m., that means he's serious. I said, fine, I'll train him. He started coming from weight of 74 kgs at the age of, 14, I got him to 52 in 3 months. No diet, nothing, just playing football freely. And doing small things that he should. Changing his attitude. Once I did that, today it's been a year almost, a year and 3 months I'd say. My academy, I have approximately 30 kids registered. Yes, I'm not a very fancy academy, but whoever kids have paid for me have had something or the other to take back home. Something or the other. Be that anything. I taught a 6-year-old kid what planets are. That's not my job. I'm a football coach, not a science teacher. Never even scored anything in science. Question about him. I feel that a football player needs to go through a full and full development. If he doesn't do that, he can't be a player. Be that any sportsman, anyone, you can spot that yes, he's a sportsman. He plays a sport. Straight off by his posture. Or his walking attitude or anything. Once I did that, Arsenal came up to me. We want to hire you. Arsenal, yes, the football team in UK. They said that we'll take your kids, like my academy, we'll absorb my academy and we'll, work something out. I said, no, I can't give you my academy, I'm sorry. It's mine. I worked on it. You can't have it. It's as simple as that. They said, fine, we love the passion, the steady work for us. Today I work with Arsenal as well. I'm a player come coach with the elite program in India itself. These kids are the shortlisted kids from all over NCR. These are 20 kids that we train. And yet, I'm 21 years old. I don't earn so much. I don't. At least not for myself. But I'm satisfied. At this point, I'm satisfied. Probably in February, I'll say, no, this is nothing much. I'll quit my job, I'll start something else. But till the time I can push on and say, yes, I'm satisfied with football, I will do it. Why? Because that's my passion. And I recently graduated, I had opportunities to work behind the desk. I'm not saying they're bad, but it's not meant for me. I can't sit on a desk and sit on my laptop and for an hour's job, I'll be 45 minutes on Facebook, 15 minutes working. I can't do that. That's not my thing. My thing is to be on the ground, working it out and playing. Why? Because that's something I do best. That's something I have an interest for. Everyone says someone or the other is God-gifted. No one's God-gifted. God just says, okay, this is the talent you have. If you have the hard work to put it, make it your, what you call, strength, you make it. If you feel like playing the violin or the piano, or even singing, anything, do it. Why? Because at the end of the day, that's what will make you happy. And that's what I've learned. I'm 21 years old. My friends work a lot. They have 9-to-5 jobs plus extra hours. Like you call them, bro, what's the scene? No, yeah, I work, I can't come, sorry. I'm like, dude, you're what, 21 and you're like, I can't come. In another 4 years, your father's going to say, beta, chal, shaadi kar le. Tere bacche. When are you going to live life? When? When you're 65, you're going to tell your kids, I used to play badminton, or I used to sing the song, and I didn't play because India. But what India? India's a bloody power. I'm lacking the term, I'm sorry. Superpower. You step out and you say, I'm going to make a difference. And see it make a difference. You don't need to be a billionaire or a millionaire. Just need to have a heart for your sport. Or for that matter, whatever you do. If you have that heart, trust me, you will break through the bricks. Trust me on that. If you don't, I'll give you my address. Come beat me over there. It's as simple as that. Because when my friends say that, bhai, you know, in class 9th and all, they used to say, Akhil, you play football, what are you going to do, man? You don't get bloody 50% in your marks. Today, I'm standing here giving a speech on TEDx. I don't want that. If I'm not saying that a 9-to-5 job is bad, if you like that, you do it. I don't like it. I work 3 times in a week. Yes, it's in the morning, 6 to 9. But at least I get up early, I have the full day to work. Or enjoy, for that matter of fact. That's all I'll end it at. That follow your passion, even if it's till the age of 21, 22. So you don't have a regret when you're 70 years old. When you're telling your grandchildren that, you know, I used to do this, your grandchildren, Papa, Papa, I'm going to eat you. What will you say? What will you say? You ask that question to yourself. What will you say? That's not going to happen. It's as simple as that. Get out there, work on it. If it happens, happens. If it doesn't, always have a plan B. It's as simple as that. Get out there, work on it. If you can do it, well and good. If you can't, fine. At least I tried. You don't have that regret. Because if you have that regret, you're going to end up screwing your life. I'm sorry to use that term. But you will. You won't be content with what you do. Thank you.